ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ. ಎಲ್ರೂ ಬೇಕಾದಷ್ಟು ಮಾತಾಡಿದೀವಿ, ನಾವು ಕೇಳಬೇಕಾಗಿದ್ದು ಅಥವಾ ಮಾತಾಡಬೇಕಿದ್ದು ಸುಮಾರು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ರಿಯಲಿ ಇಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ಐ ಕೆಪ್ ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಟೂ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ಲಿ, ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್. ಐ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೀಗ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸುರೇಂದ್ರಾಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲೆಂಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್. ಹಿ ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಟುಡೇ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 23 years ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸ್ಟಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ, ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಅಪ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ. But as I said earlier, when I started speaking, I spent a few weeks with Mr. Unni, who is a very good and close friend of mine. And it was very interesting to live with him for 4 weeks or 5 weeks. Ekendre nanu sumaru 7 gantege eddelta idde athwa 7 7 varege eddelta idde Delhi li 7 vare na eddela astralli Unni paper odi cartoon bardu cartoon email maadibittiravaru astralli. You know, so basically he had 20 hours to do all his other activities. You know, so there are people like that who produce very early in the morning. There are people like Satish Acharya who produce 4 or 5 cartoons a day sometimes, you know, and there are people who get stuck for ideas. I am sure there are many explanations for all of these things, but I think, you know, at the root of many of these questions, I am not a cartoonist, I have nothing to do with cartoons, but what I certainly know is this basic idea of how do we get ideas. I think that's a very important process in this whole cartooning business. Iga navellru, you know, yaro fully formed cartoons anta helidru Satish Acharya cartoons bage, you know, that is one way of illustrating a cartoon. Surendra avrdu is another way of illustrating, Unni avrdu is another way. So there are ways and ways of drawing a cartoon, so there is no one perfect way of drawing a cartoon, but there is really a perfect way of getting ideas. There is really a perfect way of becoming a cartoonist. So before we start that, let me ask a simple question of the students who are here. Okay, how many of you want to be a cartoonist? How many of you here in this hall want to become a cartoonist? Nimmalli yaru eshtu jana cartoonist aagbeku anta ankonidira? How many of you want to be a cartoonist? 1 2 3, just 3. I think you said you are drawing cartoons already, so that's 4. Yeah, so that's 4 people, just 4 people out of, let's say, 20 people. Okay, here is my first point. How many of you have read today's newspaper? Nimma nalak jandalli ivattina patrike yaru odidira? Okay, this is the root of getting ideas. If you are wanting to become a journalist, if you are wanting to become a political writer, if you are wanting to become a cartoonist, if you are wanting to become a photographer, if you want to become anything in journalism, anything, the first requirement is to read. And unless you read, there is no hope for you to become a journalist, cartoonist, writer, photographer, graphic artist, anything. This is a very boring topic. I'm sure your professors have told you a lot about it. I'm sure, you know, every day you are reminded on the essential need to read. But if you're not reading, then you have taken the first wrong step towards not becoming a journalist. I think if you want to become a journalist, if you want to become a cartoonist, that's the first thing. Second question people ask is, what should I read? Iga navellru nam jobali phone ide, nam jobali social media ide, nam jobali Facebook ide, navella ankotivi oh nan ottta idini appa bekadas ottta idini anta, but neevu en ottta idira adralli? Neevu ottta irudu nimge ishta irudu. ನೀವು ಓದ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ದರ್ಶನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ನೀವು ಓದ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಕರೀನಾ ಕಪೂರ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ನೀವು ಓದ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಸಚಿನ್ ತೆಂಡೂಲ್ಕರ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ವಿರಾಟ್ ಕೊಹ್ಲಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಪಬ್ ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಹೋಟ್ಲ್ ಇದೆ. ಬಟ್ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಟೂನ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಎಡಿಟೋರಿಯಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಟೂನ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ. ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ ಎ ಟೋಟ್ಲಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್. ಯು ನೋ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಐ ಮೀನ್, ವೆದರ್ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಕಾರ್ಟೂನಿಸ್ಟ್ ಜರ್ನಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್, ಎ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ, proper reading is the primary requisite. Don't think just because you vote in a democracy, just because you get a finger mark on your finger, don't think you have completed your task. If you want to be a proper citizen, forget journalist, cartoonist, photographer, the first requirement is you must read. The second requirement is you must read with certain skills, with certain expectations, with certain order, which means you should not depend on your social media feed. You should not depend on your website or your portal to read. It is absolutely important to fill your head with new thoughts, which means you must read every day like a sponge. You know, you must absorb every single day news and information which even you might not like. You know, this is the basic thing. You cannot just keep reading what you like. You just cannot keep watching what you like. You must fill your thoughts with different things, you know, to really become something in journalism or in cartooning or even to become a citizen. And you must read really history, biographies, autobiographies, culture, fiction, non-fiction. You know, this must be across the board. You know, at this age, when you are 20, 21, 22, if you are not reading across the board, and if you are just reading what pleases you, what makes you feel nice, that's not the way to go about it. If you want to become a journalist, you must read across the board. It's a very important thing. For people like me, who have really been in journalism for quite long, I can tell you that you should know that the greatest cartoon character in the world is a journalist. Tintin. How many of you have read Tintin? How many of you students have read Tintin here? Okay? So if you have not read Tintin, look at how involved you are in this profession of journalism. You know, you must do things like this. The greatest movie made in history is on journalism. It's called Citizen Kane. The greatest play made in the world, or the most watched play made in the world, is made on journalism. So look at how beautiful journalism is, in the sense that the greatest cartoon, Tintin, the greatest movie, Citizen Kane, the greatest play, which then became His Girl Friday, it's called His Girl Friday, they're all about journalism. So the basic point I'm trying to make is that unless you read across the board, you know, you're not going to do very much. You know, so I think that's a really primary requirement, which is read history, read politics, read culture, read fiction, non-fiction, comics, books, magazines, newspapers. Unless you read and fill your head with thoughts and ideas and people and places you did not know of, you are not going to be a good journalist or a good cartoonist. I hope people like Mr. Surendra and Satish Acharya correct me, but this is the primary requirement. Read, read and read. It's not enough to just get WhatsApp forwards, social media, Facebook posts, you know, Adela, that's all bullshit. You know, I mean, you need to read good quality stuff. If you haven't read Gabriel Garcia Marquez, what is the point of life? Who is Gabriel Garcia Marquez? Gabriel Garcia Marquez, how many of you have heard of him? Mr. Marquez, one person out of 20. Marquez, no Marquez, Gabriel Garcia Marquez. Name a book. 100 Years of Solitude, okay? Gabriel Garcia Marquez is a Nobel Prize winning writer. Nobel Prize winning writer. But before he became a Nobel Prize winning writer, he was a journalist. He was a journalist. Look at a book released earlier this year called A Scandal of the Century, right? Something like that. A Scandal of the Century released earlier this year. A collection of Mr. Marquez's writings. Brilliant man. Where, unlike any prize winner in this third-rate country of ours, he says, my journalism is better than my Nobel Prize award. Here you talk to any award winner, he'll say, oh my God, I'm just the award. Nothing else matters. But Mr. Marquez has the humility to say that my journalism is more important than my writing, which fetched me a Nobel Prize. Imagine an Indian wins a Nobel Prize, or a Pakistani, or a Bangladeshi, or an American. You think that the award is higher to where you started off from. But Mr. Marquez reads journalism and writes journalism. So look at what we have. Tintin, Citizen Kane, Mr. Marquez, The Greatest Play. All of them are about journalism. So therefore, there is something about journalism which is absolutely magical. And you must read and read and read and read. The third thing I will say is this. You know, this is not a point Mr. Surendra made or Satish Acharya made, because they are now professionals. They are now professionals. They make their money from this, but that's not enough. Okay? They are at the top of the pile. But if you are going to start out as a journalist, if you are going to start out as a cartoonist, you must draw every single day. You must draw every single day. You must draw while you're sitting here if you're interested in cartooning. You must sketch wherever possible. You know? I don't know who it was. Somebody asked a question in the earlier round. But let me give you an example. Somebody else also mentioned, yeah, I was watching Unni, he was saying something. But let me say you this. How many of you have heard of Jaitirtha Mevundi? How many of you have heard of Jaitirtha Mevundi? The Hindustani musical vocal singer. He's from around this part of the world, just north, up north. Jaitirtha Mevundi is one of the top Hindustani classical singers today. When he went to start learning music, he went to a man whose son is a top tabla artist today called Rajendra Nakur. Rajendra Nakur nan helidru, ivanu Jaitirtha Mevundi nam mane bandaga kaliyakke nam tande inda kaliyodike bandaga emme tara aadta idda anta. He used to sing like a buffalo. Jitendra Mevundi, Jaitirtha Mevundi used to sing like a buffalo anta Rajendra Nakur nagnakta helidru. Yake andre ಅದೇ ಜೈತೀರ್ಥ ಮೇವುಂಡಿ ಅವರು ಇವತ್ತು ಎಮ್ಮೆ ತರ ಅಲ್ಲ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ತರ ಆಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಯುನೋ ಎ ಸೂಪರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಮೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಭೀಮಸೇನ್ ಜೋಶಿ ಹೌ ಡಿಡ್ ಜೈತೀರ್ಥ ಮೇವುಂಡಿ ಎ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಪೂರ್ ಸಿಂಗರ್ ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಬಫಲೋ ಹೌ ಡಿಡ್ ಹಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿ ಸ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಡೇ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಜರ್ನಲಿಸಂ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ are writing beside some stupid posts on Facebook, stupid tweets of 180 characters, 280 characters. How many of us are writing every single day? Okay? This is what makes us perfect. This is what gives the perfection that Mr. Surendra and Satish Acharya have. Satish Acharya's illustrations, if you see them, have evolved over a period of time. Correct me if I'm wrong. You know, they evolve. It's no longer the unformed thing, you know, Gujarat nor Hiltaidru, you know. It has changed, it has evolved, it's become a very full-formed set of illustrations. How does that happen? It does not happen because he's some genius. He might be a genius, but it happens because he's practicing every single day. That is absolutely important. So therefore, that is my point number three, which is besides you read and read and read, besides reading across the board, you must start to draw every single day. You must sketch something or the other every single day if you're wanting to become a cartoonist. If you just want to become a journalist, you must start writing every single day, you know, and you must start writing something serious, not that you went for a pub, you took a selfie, you took a this thing, you took a food, we're not talking about that, something serious, you know, this is a serious business. Idralli, we might laugh a little, we might smile a little when you look at these cartoons, but the truth is that there's a lot of seriousness about this, you know, so many of you ask, you know, are you not afraid to air this opinion? Are you not afraid, you know, that you'll be hit by some vandals, that you'll be attacked, etc., etc.? But those are all different issues. The issue is this, which is that you've learned to draw, you have learned to air an opinion, and you have the confidence to air that opinion. That's very important. And unless you draw every single day, unless you write every single day, and not just a state, you know, status update or a Facebook post or a tweet, you know, you need to write every single day. This is what makes things happen. How many of you have heard of Malcolm Gladwell? Malcolm Gladwell. How many of you? Malcolm Gladwell. Malcolm Gladwell is a writer who wrote a very famous book called Outliers. Outliers. He says, for any of us to achieve any kind of perfection in anything, we need to have done it for 10,000 hours. For a pilot, you need to have flown an aircraft 10,000 hours. For a writer, I would say 10,000 hours. Mr. Surendra, over 23 years, 10,000 hours, for sure, 10,000 hours. So all this comes from practicing every single day. Bhimsen Joshi used to do riyaz at the age of 81. Every single morning, the greatest Hindustani vocalist in India used to do riyaz every single day. So what stops us in journalism from doing these things? What stops us from doing this if you want to be a cartoonist, a writer, a photographer? You know, so therefore, you know, these are repetitive points, but I repeat, and you'll pardon me for that, but I think we need to do this consistently. It needs to become what is called muscle memory. Muscle memory, which means, you know, I hope the cartoonists here will agree with me. When you move your hand, your muscles remember how to move. It's called muscle memory. Okay? Same thing with photography, same thing with talking. you know, same thing with a whole lot of activities. So this kind of regular practice, writing, reading, you know, drawing, sketching, all these develop some kind of, you know, muscle memory, which is useful for us in the long run. Fourthly, it's very important for all of you young people, if you want to become cartoonists. Somebody asked a question about the avenues. Some senior man here asked about the avenues for cartooning. Okay, Satish Acharya gave you one example, which is that you have various avenues today. You have websites, you have portals, you have a whole lot of things to contribute to. But that is at the end of the line. Before you graduate from your schools and colleges, I think young people like you must have your own portfolio. You must have your own body of work, you know, whether it is pictures, cartoons, articles, or whatever it is you have done, or letters to the editor, whatever it is you have done in journalism, unless you have a portfolio of work, you are starting out on the back foot. It's a very competitive market, there are very few jobs, and unless you have something demonstrated to show that you can do this, you are not going to be on the right foot starting here. Fifthly, I think it's very important to slowly start developing a style, which I'm sure most of us will know, but we'll only develop a style if we're reading enough, if we are absorbing enough, and if we are thinking enough. So we need to develop a style. But the most important thing I'll say is that we have to learn to take a stand. We have to learn to take a stand, and we have to learn to face criticism. We should not be afraid of taking a stand. You know, so many of the questions here are built around fear. It tells you about the India we are beginning to inhabit, where we feel afraid, where we feel fearful of saying what we should say, as if it's a crime. It is not a crime to say what we feel. It's not a crime to say whatever stand we want to take. It's very important to say so. If you don't have that basic courage, don't become a cartoonist. Don't become a journalist. Become a software engineer. Become a banker. Become a troll army soldier. But don't become a journalist. Because this business is about taking a stand. We are not here to please anybody. We are not here to win a popularity contest. You don't like my opinion? Tough. You have to hear it. You have an opinion? Please say it. I will accept it. I might not agree with it, but that's the basic thing here in journalism. We must learn to take a stand. And all good political cartooning comes out of taking a stand. How many of you have heard of Charlie Hebdo? How many of you have heard of Charlie Hebdo? Charlie Hebdo. Charlie Hebdo is a magazine where cartoonists were killed in cold blood for the cartoons they produced in France 5 years ago, 4 years ago, okay, 2014, 15, whatever it was. Cartoonists have paid with their lives for the cartoons they have done, okay, but that is what is called courage. I don't mean to say all of us need to die. I don't mean to say all of us need to be attacked, but I think journalism in its very nature requires courage from us. Whether you become this, that or the other, journalism is about this. It's about taking a stand. It's about learning to face criticism. It's not a popularity contest. I think, to come to the sixth and perhaps the penultimate point, you know, you need to find new avenues to get your work across. You know, you live in this magnificent age of social media, of digital journalism, and so on and so forth. At this point of time, Mr. Surendra draws for a hard copy newspaper, which gets onto the website. Satish does it for a whole variety of newspapers and websites, but I don't know, and they don't know what will come in the future. You know, so you need to find new avenues of getting your word across. For example, let's say you have 256 friends on your WhatsApp group. You know, if you sketch or write or photograph every day, can you send it across to all 256 every day? Can you send your work every day to all these people? So this is one way of finding new avenues. This is a new avenue. A cartoon habba is a new avenue of getting cartoons across. Correct me. You know. So I think you need to find, as young people, new ways of taking your work across, whether as cartoonists or photographers or writers. Most importantly, I think all of you in this age, especially 24, 23, 22, this age, you need to learn stamina. You need to learn to have some stamina. Rahul Dravid, probably the most patient batsman the world has known, has something called stamina. That's the key thing between a key difference between a Rahul Dravid and a Sachin Tendulkar. Rahul Dravid has faced more test match balls than any batsman on earth ever. More balls than anybody else. He has only missed one test match because of injury. What does that show you? It talks to you about the stamina of the man. That is physical stamina. What young people like you need is mental stamina. Okay? You think I have drawn a cartoon, it must be published. It won't be published. Nobody owes you a favor. You think you have written a great piece, you send it to Mr. Ramakrishna and he does not publish it, you feel dejected. You should feel dejected because Mr. Ramakrishna has every right to reject your piece. So the point is, learning stamina means how do you stay for 40 minutes standing here and speaking? How do you face rejection? How do you accept no for an answer? Do you know the name of a man called Regret Iyer? How many of you know the name of a man called Regret Iyer? Regret Iyer. Nobody? One? Who's the man? Regret Iyer is a cartoonist. A cartoonist from Bangalore whose primary claim to fame is that he collected the rejection slips of a lot of newspapers and magazines who said, we regret we cannot publish your cartoon. We regret we cannot publish your piece. What does Mr. Regret Iyer do? He makes rejection a part of his life and still continues to draw and shoot and paint and eventually gets published and becomes a star. Look at his son, a fantastic product of a man, Regret Iyer, who's now a top photographer in the US. Okay? So the point is that these people have learned how to assimilate rejection and failure. They have learned how to deal with rejection and they have learned to stay the course. Mr. Surendra got a job and luckily got a job for 23 years. I can assure you, none of you will get a job which will last 23 years. None of you. I won't get a job which will last 23 years. He was lucky. Satish was lucky for a while. Mr. Ramakrishna is again lucky now. But I don't know how long we'll all be lucky. So therefore, it's important for us to deal with rejection, failure, and you feel you don't have the strength to face this. But that's the truth. Okay? Our business in journalism is to tell you the hard truth. You might not like it, tough luck to you. Okay? So learn to find a stamina. Stamina. And penultimately, learn about the legends. Learn about the legends if you want to become a cartoonist, if you want to become a journalist. Okay? We are just one link in the long chain of people who have been before us and after us. Before Mr. Surendra, there was cartoonists. After Satish Acharya, there will be cartoonists. After Mr. Gujarappa, there will be cartoonists. There will be a long chain. But before us, there have been a lot of legends who have passed this track. A number of legends in journalism, in literature, in theater, in film, and so on and so forth. And we must learn from these legends if we want to go anywhere. You know, it's not enough to just listen to somebody talk about all this very glibly. It's very important to know. For example, Steve Waugh. I don't know how many of you have heard of Steve Waugh, the Australian fantastic legendary captain. Steve Waugh, whenever he took the Australian team to England, he would take them to a battlefield called Garibaldi, you know, in England. And that was because in this place in England, a number of Australian soldiers lost their lives. So before the Australians played a single match in England, he would take them to a place where Australian soldiers were killed. And his great line is this: if you do not know where you come from, you will never know where to go. If you do not know where you come from, you will never know where to go. So whether you want to become a journalist or a cartoonist or anything, photographer, publisher, you know, writer, whatever, unless you know that these are the great people who have inhabited this, you know, universe, we will go nowhere because we need to learn from them. We need to follow the great cartoonists of the world. David Lowe. David Lowe was the cartoonist who inspired R.K. Lakshman. David Lowe was the cartoonist who inspired fantastic work by Bal Thackeray. You might be surprised, but Bal Thackeray is an outstanding cartoonist, perhaps a better cartoonist than a politician. You know, but he is a fantastic cartoonist. So these people learned from David Lowe, R.K. Lakshman, Herb Lock. You know, if you're wanting to do a career in cartooning, you must know the work of Herb Lock, the Washington Post cartoonist for a very, very long time. Legend, you know, you must know these people. You must know the work of P. Shankar Pillai, you know, the man who published Shankar's Weekly in India. You must know about O.V. Vijayan, the outstanding, magic realist writer, O.V. Vijayan, and a cartoonist. Abu Abraham, great cartoonist, you know. Just two, 3 days back, you know, you had the governor of Maharashtra or the President of India actually 2-3 nights back signing a proclamation at 5:47 a.m. in the morning declaring President's rule in, declaring the revocation of President's rule in Maharashtra. Abu Abraham did a very great cartoon in 1975 where he showed the President of India signing the emergency proclamation from a bathtub. In 1975, Abu Abraham, the great cartoonist, showed the President of India signing an ordinance for the declaration of emergency from the bathtub. Imagine in the bathtub, imagine now at 5:47 a.m. what the President of India should be doing and what cartoons these guys missed. If Abu Abraham could show them, show the President of India in the bathtub, where should they have shown Ramnath Kovind at 5:47 a.m.? This is a challenge I throw to all of you here. If you have the courage, let's do this. Okay? So follow the heroes of your world. Follow the heroes of your world. O.V. Vijayan, Abu Abraham, R.K. Lakshman, Rajinder Puri. I never heard the word Rajinder Puri. Superb cartoonist. Superb cartoonist, Rajinder Puri. Kutti. Again, great cartoonist you must follow. Bal Thackeray, of course. And of course, the absolutely legendary Mario Miranda. Just up north from here, from Goa. You know, fantastic cartoonist. So you must learn to follow the legends, not just out of respect, but just to see how cartooning has evolved over a period of time, just to see how journalism has evolved, just to see how much India has evolved or devolved. Okay? So it's very important to do some of these things. And finally, I'll say this much. You must follow your contemporaries also. Not just follow the, you know, learn about the legends, but also follow the contemporaries. You know, look at Mr. Unni's work. Look at my friend, colleague, Sandeep Adwari's work in the Times of India. Look at Prasad, again a friend of mine, again a colleague of mine in the Economic Times. Ajit Nainan, of course, you know, in all our discussions, we are not hearing of women cartoonists. Why? So many of you women ask questions. Why aren't there women cartoonists in India? Why aren't you guys trying to fill that block? Why do we only know of Manjula Padmanabhan? Why do we only know of Maya Kamath? You know, why aren't there more women cartoonists? If you are a smart girl, if you are a smart girl, I would say, if you have any journalism in your blood, you must try to fill these blanks. This is an open area. You know, what is journalism? It's just good opportunity. You know, why am I speaking here? Just because I have the opportunity. Similarly, you have the option, the open space to become a cartoonist or a writer or an illustrator or whatever it is. And I think these are the ways I would advise you. So therefore, you know, he asked me to give you some advice. So these are my pieces of advice. Read across the board. Draw every single day. Write every single day. Build a portfolio. Develop your own style. You know, take a stand. Do not hesitate to be criticized. You know, be open to criticism. Find new avenues to push your work. Learn to get some stamina in your legs and in your mind, in between your ears. Okay, you need to get stamina between your ears. Learn about the legends of our profession and follow the contemporary superstars. So these are my pieces of advice that I can give you. And I'll close with this one final comment, which is this. Nobody can teach you journalism. Nobody, not even Mr. Surendra, not even R.K. Lakshman, not even David Lowe, nobody, not even Mr. Gujarappa, nobody can teach you journalism. But you can learn journalism. I hope you appreciate the difference. Nobody can teach you, but you can learn if you have it in you. And these 9 things will help you. Thank you very much.
Because Krishna Prasad said we have to leave for airport. Any questions?
You must feel, as a journalist, very courageous to ask absolutely stupid questions like what I ate this morning.
First of all, thank you for the last statement. So my question is, you might be aware of the latest trend, troll memes. So, as a platform, considering we have both a cartoonist and a journalist, I think this question can be relevant or super relevant. So, my question is, when I see a troll meme, the only way I can differentiate a troll meme from a cartoon is the aspect of drawing. Other than that, I see it as an artist way of depicting a meaningful thing through humor. So far, the troll memes haven't occupied the columns of the newspaper. I'm a journalist. What do you think? Are troll memes going to occupy the columns of newspapers just like the cartoons have occupied?
Thank you.
How do you differentiate between drawn memes and cartoons, or do you think these two are the two sides of a single coin?
I have a very simple, clear answer on these things. I am a journalist. I'm proud to be a journalist. Memes are created, cartoons are created by names we know. We know who these people are. We trust them. They're credible, even if we don't agree with them. Memes, etc., are all created by people I don't know. Okay? I don't know who creates these memes. Nobody has told me the author, the name, etc., etc. One. Two. These people do these cartoons to put out an opinion. They put their name to it. You might not agree with it. They are not drawing a cartoon to offend anybody or to create hatred about anybody. That's a very key difference. These memes are about creating hatred about some community, about some person, about some issue. Okay? So these are not very innocent things as they seem today. You might think that there's a very small artistic difference, but I think there's a very huge difference about the intent and objective. So in my opinion, there's no space for these things in proper journalistic places of work. Of course, I see a lot of newspapers using this. I see a lot of television stations using that, but that does not make it okay. Journalism is about truth, verification, re-verification, authentication, etc., etc. We still make a lot of mistakes despite all that. Okay? But on the other hand, in the case of trolls and memes and so on, we don't know the source, we don't know the intent, and almost always the intent is hatred. Almost always. They want you to hate somebody. They want you to hate this person. They want you to hate this party. They want you to hate this issue. They want you to not talk about certain issues. You know, so there's a very big difference between trolls and journalists. You know, I am a journalist, proud to be a journalist. Okay? I want to see a troll who will stand up and say, I'm a troll, I'm proud to be a troll. Let's meet that troll.